This has been a reflective time for you in March. Also, some things have happened probably in February that really opened your eyes and opened your heart to some healing for you. It was challenging and it was tough to get there, but now looking back on it and looking back on March, you'll see how much you have grown as a person and how you could actually accomplish and deal with different aspects of your life. So March is, you know, even though like the beginning of March was probably very challenging and in some ways kind of gut-wrenching, heart-wrenching, you're coming out stronger and better because of it. So let's pull a second card for that one. All right, so Page of Cups. So with this card, I do feel like some of you guys started dating someone who has a child. Either you got pregnant or you are dating someone who is younger, but somehow a child entered your life in March, and this Page of Cups energy is unconditional love that you haven't had before. And so it's interesting and cultivating for you to have to kind of meet this person at their level of unconditional. And so this is probably why your heart opened and your heart space was cracked, you know, with the Hanged Man energy of, oh my gosh, I didn't know that I could love like this. I didn't know there was a capacity for this. And if a child didn't come into your life, then I think you saw like a children's movie or saw something that was very youthful that just says, oh my gosh, I have forgotten what that feels like. And it's kind of a gift to you, all right? Aquarius was a gift to you to remind you of what it's like to be youthful, to be vibrant, and to love without boundaries. In April, we have the Eight of Cups. So the Eight of Cups is you're going to have to walk away from something that's not necessarily terrible. It's not great. It's not the one and only, but it is something that you just know it's time to move on. So it could be a job that's, you know, the pay is good, the hours are good, you're doing just fine, but you know that you have bigger, better things, and so it's time for you to move on. And if you aren't moving on, then this is a time to start planning for it because it needs to happen sooner than later. And if you initiate it now, universe will really help you in finding what the next thing is that is better suited for you. All right, April. So the next card in April is the Six of Cups reverse. So this is just warning not to take a step back and go into like the nostalgia realm of, you know, you're supposed to be moving forward. You're supposed to be pushing into the next thing. And so there is this possibility of you actually taking a step back and going, well, remember when this happened? Oh, why couldn't that past thing happen? Maybe I can relive it. Maybe I can make it happen now. No. Be cultivating. Be creative. Push forward. Do something new. Take the lessons that you learned in the past and apply them to now, but don't live in the past. That is not where the energy that you need, and that's not the energy that's going to get you to where you need to go. So remember, if you start to go down that realm of nostalgia, that's fine. Take that moment to remember and then move on. In May, we have the Six of Wands, and this is a celebration. So May is a good month for you. You know, it's going to be a victory. You're going to get some accolades of some sort. Either it's at work or a relationship. Maybe you guys get engaged. Maybe, you move in. But it's something that is celebratory happening in your life. And it's going to help you find balance, too. This is great. So Two of Pentacles is that of balance and trying to find that balance. And so this celebration is going to help you with that. It also might be a challenge as well that you come back successful, and so you want to kind of stay on that high. But what you have to do is actually ground yourself and be like, yep, I got to that level. I got to what I wanted. Now I have to keep working. So when this happens, when this positive victory happens, once again, kind of similar to the energy of April, revel in it, you know, revel in that moment and then move on. Okay, just like in April, where it's, if you're going into nostalgia, you can go into it, but you have to move on. That way you can stay in balance for what's to come, which is another celebration. You know, Three of Cups is enjoying friends and family, and this is in June. So June is a good month to go out with friends. It's a good time to connect with people. You are the life of the party. People want to be around you, Aquarius. You're just like you're a people magnet, okay? All right, and then with that people magnet, if you're drawing people together, that's, you're drawing the good and the negative. Okay, so with the Queen of Wands reverse, this is somebody, I think, who's a little bit jealous of you, just naturally being the center of attention. So with the Queen of Wands reverse, it's somebody who wants to be the center of attention, wants everyone to focus on them, and they're not, because they're too busy focusing on what you're doing and who you are. So they might try to sabotage some of your things. So if this is somebody at work, just be careful that you're being very, not secretive, but that you have some discernment about who you are sharing your ideas and your projects with. Because this person's going to be listening and trying to figure out a way to take the attention from you and put it on them. My fear here is that this person is going to try to steal an idea from you or steal a person from you, you know, because if this isn't at work, then this is in friends and family. And so they're trying to take what you have because they want to be the, you know, the one and the only. So just have some discernment about who you surround yourself with and who you are opening up to. And even if it is a close friend or family member, this is also, it's an, it's a fire sign. So this is Scorpio, Leo, Sagittarius energy. And if it is somebody who is close to you, if you get that vibe, like, ooh, maybe I shouldn't tell them everything, you know, I just feel this, that's not the time, please listen to that. That'll help you in the long run. So in July, we have the Empress. See, Aquarius, you're just having good month after good month after good month with just a little hair of challenges. But the Empress is so fertile. So July, if you don't want to get pregnant, then be careful, because you are just fertile physically, mentally, socially, emotionally. You've got the greatest ideas. You could have a baby if you're not careful, and if you want to, congratulations. You're just filled with beauty. You're abound with Venusian things. If you want to change your house around, if you want to change appearance in some regard, this is a great time to do it. You've got Venus on your side. So July, if you want to make some cosmetic shifts in your life, whether it be personal or around your house or, you know, your garden, whatever, it's a good time to do it. All right, so the Nine of Pentacles in reverse, which is very similar to the Empress card. However, this is in reverse. So with this happening, it's almost contradictory, having the Empress and the Nine of Pentacles in reverse. Most of the aspects in your life are going to be creative. Most of the aspects in your life are going to be fertile. There's going to be a couple aspects in your life that you're just going to be stumped by. So if everything's going well in work, if you are being creative at home, if things are really taking off with a relationship, you know, you might not be as creative at work. It's like you can't have it all. You can't have your cake and eat it too kind of energy. But the Empress trumps the Nine of Pentacles. So if you are stumped in some regard when it comes to aspects of your life, ask for help. You know, ask other people for opinions or ideas. And that'll kind of catapult you into a creative realm. And you can just take off with that and come back. All in all, though, July is a great month to start things. And if you are stumped, like I said, just look at it from a different venue and it'll come together. August. This month, I actually see people getting married or you guys going to weddings. August, the initiate is the Hierophant card, so it has to do with religion, organization, community. You are really gathering with community that month, Aquarius. You're gathering with your tribe. Things are happening there. Oh, and so many things are happening, it's going to be hard for you to choose. So don't feel obligated to do it all. Choose the ones that you really want to be at, and then just let the other ones know that you are booked, you know? You don't have to be at every single event, but there are some events that you definitely need to mark as important. Those ones, make sure you go. All the rest, if you make it, you make it. If you don't, you don't. It's okay. Everyone wants you at all the events. Just pick and choose which ones you want, and it's fine. Pick your favorites. All right, so that's August, September. We have the King of Pentacles happening, King of Discs. Now, with this card, somebody's coming in. You could be starting a new relationship if you aren't already in one. And they're solid, you know? It's in the upright. So this is an earth energy, Capricorn, Taurus or Virgo energy, and they're coming in. They're very stately. They have all of their ducks in a row. They know what they want out of life, and they're making it happen. You know, they're stable. They're a stable entity for you. Okay, so then we have the lovers in reverse. They're coming in. They're amazing. They're not the one. Bummer. The lovers in reverse is a lesson that you have to learn. So I think they're coming in to show you what is available and show you what you are worth so that when the real person comes along, you can accept them. Aquarius, this is the energy that's happening for September is you're worth so much more than you've been putting into yourself. You've been, you know, kind of cutting yourself short and not giving yourself the full reign of your beauty, of your life. And so this person is coming in to say, look at how amazing you are, Aquarius. Look at the world around you. We love you and we adore you. And it's a surprise to you, actually, Aquarius. You're like, what are you talking about? I mean, I know I'm fine, but why do you like me so much? Well, it's so that you know when the person comes in that you deserve it and that you deserve all the beauty and unconditional love that has been pouring on you for this entire time, since March until September. Like constantly, the lesson is find love, find creativity, and use it. Utilize it and make it part of your life, make it part of you. And so this person is lovely, handsome, really well off, but just there's no spiritual connection. There's no spidey sense about them, but they are such a wonderful human being so that you know that you deserve Mr. or Mrs. Wonderful, okay? October, we have the Eight of Swords. So I don't think this relationship, if you're just meeting someone, is going to last that long. It's going to kind of come in and come out. And you know, it's like I think you could break up like very quickly within, you know, 4 to 8 weeks. And it bums you out, you know? There's something that's going to bum you out in October, but the thing is it's so easy to let go, you know? It's like you know that it wasn't meant to happen, that it wasn't meant to be, you know, forever. So you can enjoy it for the time that it is and then let it go. And if you can't, please listen to this. It wasn't meant to last forever. It wasn't meant to be always, always, always. It was meant to be this short snippet of time so that you can put that little bit in your heart and then watch it grow. Okay, so Four of Cups in reverse. Again, it's that energy of moving on, you know? Four of Cups when it's upright is I don't want anymore. I don't want anymore. Well, now it's like you're like, now I'm pushing it away and I don't need anymore, and it's time for me to move on and be master of my destiny. So Aquarius, if something bums you out in October, like a loss of a relationship, or maybe you didn't get the promotion, or you wanted to buy a couch and it was out of stock, something like that, then it's okay, because what's to come is better. But it's just accepting that and actually embodying that idea that is complicated. It's easy to say, like, I know, there's always a silver lining, but to actually embody that is tougher than just saying it. And that will be your challenge in October. In November, we have the Wheel of Fortune in reverse. So this is still a good card, even though it's in reverse. And you're going to get what you want. It's just going to take some more time and it's going to take some more work. The Wheel of Fortune is expansion. When it's in reverse, it's still expansion, but it's just at a very much slower pace. So this is a Jupiter energy of how much can we give you? How much can we make? Also, I do feel like Jupiter will have started, or have it's already gone direct, because it's actually reverse right now, so I think it goes direct by that time. So it's time to get it going. It's time to move forward. Okay, Four of Pentacles in reverse. So both of these are in reverse. So it's like the Four of Pentacles is asking you're not saving enough of your life, you're not saving enough of finances or of time for you or time for the family. It's time to reprioritize your life. What is important to you? And if it's important to you, make time for it. This is also going to help with the expansion of Jupiter and the Wheel of Fortune, is by you prioritizing, yes, this means something to me. I'm going to give it time. I'm going to give it space in my life. And by doing that, that's signaling to the universe, okay, they're the real deal. They really want this to happen. Let's help them. Let's give them a nudge. And how they're going to give you a nudge is in December. December is the Ten of Swords reverse. And with the Ten of Swords in reverse, it's an ending. It's an ending that has needed to happen, that has been in the making for some time. You can see the writing on the wall, and it finally just gives, It gives, it breaks. And you knew it was going to happen. You might not have wanted it to happen, but you knew it was going to happen anyways. And this is universe saying, okay, you're serious about what you want? Okay, then we got to clean house. We got to clean this ship and get it in tip-top shape. All right, and that means that we got to let go of something. So if a relationship ends, also for some of you, I do see some family members or some people just transitioning, whether it be physically or it could be physically that they're just moving on, or they're moving, just it could be some major transitions in that regard. And but it's you knew it was going to happen, okay? And the Magician reverse. So with the Magician reverse with this, Aquarius, you're going to want to control the situation. You're going to want to stop it. You're going to want to make sure that it doesn't happen. That's not your job, and that's not what you're supposed to be doing. Actually, what you need to be doing is going with the flow, accepting the fate of your life, and going with it, and using that energy to create and manifest what's next, instead of trying to halt the reins and halt your life. All right, the Magician reverse is you have the tools, but you're not using them correctly. Okay, you have what you need, but you're not applying them to the right source. So let go, Aquarius, in December. Let go and just accept the fate and use that to propel you forward, instead of, digging in your heels and trying to stop what is happening. It's going to happen. Do it gracefully. January, we have the Ten of Pentacles reverse. I feel like you guys are going to really dig your heels in December and just, you know, be like, no, 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 I don't want to. And because of that, that's just going to cause some complications in your personal life and in your family life. And it's going to make you unsettled with people around you. That's why I'm saying you got to go with the flow. I know you are powerful beings. I know that, Aquarius. But this one is out of your hands. What you can control is your reaction to it. All right? So in January, don't take it out on other people. You know, what happened did happen. And so let's accept that fate and then deal with it as the true nature of what it truly is. And look forward, Three of Wands, you know, look forward, time to plan ahead, let's do that. You know, I do feel like the December situation, you might have blown a little bit out of proportion. You know, like it could have been you threw a holiday party, no one came. And so you feel like you're socially, you're dead. But you're not, you're fine. It was just you did it on the night that there were seven other parties and, you know, and you also made them pay to come and, you know, there could be all these different things that you thought were fine and like the magician in reverse, you were using your tools but just not in the right way. And it's small, but it just, you blow it out of proportion and all of a sudden you make it like the center of your world. It could also be, you know, much larger things, but it could be small like that. And so you've been carrying it on into January, like this sense of humiliation, this sense of rocking your family. But no, just let it go and move on. Like it's not as big of a deal as you think it is. Okay, if it is a larger deal, if it is like a loss of a family member or a friend, or you know, a divorce, you saw it happening. You knew it was going to happen. It didn't. It's not something that just happened out of the blue. It doesn't make it any easier to process and to get through, but you have a cushion, and you also have a future to look forward to. Don't lose sight of that. In February, we have the Ace of Wands, so this is a new beginning, new relationship. It could be a new job, a new hobby. Fire energy, Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. Think of lots of playing. Think of having lots of friends. Think of being really creative and charming. You know, it's somebody, it could be somebody who just lights you on fire passionately, who you want to take out with and show everyone who you're with. And it could be, you know, a job or a situation, once again, that just heats you up, makes you excited, revs you to continue in it. So it's a new beginning. So it, as I always say with new beginnings, it's what you put into it at this point. Yes, it's exciting. We're in the honeymoon phase, but let's see if you it's up to you to carry it through. All right, Seven of Wands. So this new beginning, other people are going to want it. Okay, so whether it's a person or a job, and you're going to have to kind of stand up for yourself and say, nope, this is mine. I love it. I'm going to keep it by my side. Nope, nope, nope. So you've got a gem. You could either be the gem or you're getting a gem. But it's widely coveted. Okay, so a lot of people want it. So take care of it and be grateful and thankful for it and take care of it, okay? And in March, we have the Emperor reversed. So this could be you wanted to move. You wanted something to shift. You wanted to promote yourself or something, and it falls through, all right? So the Emperor in reverse is, kind of losing the battle but not the war kind of energy. It's being stilted. The energy just stops for a moment, okay? And it's like, wait, halt, halt. The Queen of Swords showing up in this really does make sense because, the halt, that's not going to happen. It's, like I said, it's just the battle, not the war, because the Emperor always outplays the Queen of Swords. But the Queen of Swords in reverse is a fellow air sign. So that's going to be Libra, Aquarius, Gemini. And it could be you, but I don't think so. I don't think you're the one who's in reverse here. But they find all the faults in what you're doing. They find the faults even if they're not there. And they can be manipulative and twist the truth in their favor. And so they do that to you, and because of that, it halts your energy, it halts the situation or a relationship, and so you can't move forward until you deal with the Queen of Swords. And the best way to deal with a reverse Queen of Swords is not to respond. Like they have such a tight, like, they can slice and dice, slice and dice, slice and dice. And they're looking for a reaction. They're looking to bring you down. They're looking for you to break. And if you don't do any of those things, they don't know what to do. If you say to them, it's not, you're not worth my breath kind of attitude, they don't know what to do. And it does make them furious. And sometimes it can backfire and they go like 10 times harder. But still, if you, even when they go 10 times harder, if you still stand your ground and just be like, you're not worth it. You're not worth my time. Your actions are not worth my time. That just makes them mad. And then they have nothing to work with. All right, because you can't work with somebody who's manipulating and lying about the situation. Keep your work clear, keep what you're doing concise, and keep it to yourself, okay? In March, just keep it to yourself. And what I love is in April we have the sun. It's like you just washed away that Queen of Swords and the Emperor in reverse, and you're like, forget you. I am stronger and better than that. And so you stand up tall, and you victory is yours in April. The sun is shining, Leo energy, happiness, joy, being the center of attention, humor, comedy. All that lovely things happening. And then we have the moon. So this could really make you emotional, that, like, it's kind of like you've made it. You finally made it, and things are finally happening for you. And you just kind of get like teary-eyed and kind of choked up here and there. And so let it flow, let it flow. Good job, Aquarius. I'm an Aquarius moon, so I am banking on this reading for my year instead of my Cancer and Virgo readings, because this one's just a tad bit better than theirs. So, but we have all three. I'm a Cancer sun, Virgo ascendant, Aquarius moon. So this energy here is, you get to take a breath in April and just a sigh of relief that you did what you needed to do, and enjoy it. Enjoy it. Okay, so I'm gonna pull from the No Anafu deck, which is the visionary cards, just to give you a card to always come back to through the year. Freedom. Oh, that's so wonderful. You have the freedom to be who you want to be. And also within freedom, you are creating freedom for others by living in your truth, by living who you are, by being honest, by not digging in your heels, but going with the flow of your life. You are free to be the beautiful human that you are. Please always plant those roots down, let them grow, but sway with the wind. People are watching you, and you are a wonderful, wonderful source of inspiration and acknowledgement, towards that of beauty, towards that of truly being yourselves and being eclectic for those around you.